We are about 10 days out from the end of 2017, at least when this recording was made. And I think it's typical and natural to be in a reflective mood. I have, anyways. I have been in this reflective state of mind, looking back at the year and all that has happened, all that has traversed in my life. And in this mode of reflecting and looking back, I came to a startling conclusion. Something that I thought I was done with, or that I thought that I was above. A fear, a rational, or rather irrational fear, that was still working within me. The fear of failure. I didn't realize until I started looking back how much that fear had a strong hold on me. The fear of failure. I think deeper than the word failure is the word death. I think all men fear death, and failure is a representation of death. Failure usually signifies the end of a thing, the unsuccessful ending of a thing. Death is the same way, isn't it? It is the end of all ends, the one thing man is yet to fully conquer. Death, failure. I think failure is the vanguard of death. It is like the advance payment, if you will, on the end of all things. And yet, in all of my supposed awakening journey, I thought I had overcome it. I thought I had no fear of the end anymore. But alas, that was a lie I told myself. I have been afraid. I have been afraid at failing in many things. I have been afraid in failing in taking up my passion and running with it. I have been afraid of failing in giving myself fully to what I believe I can do and contribute to this world. Is that rational? To be afraid? I don't think it is a bad thing to be afraid. I think it's a bad thing to not admit it. Because you see, in my admitting it to myself, besides the clarity it gave me, there was a burden lifted. A fear of failure is but the incipient fear of death, and death is inevitable, then it's logical to conclude that failure is inevitable too. Why should one fear that which is inevitable? It's illogical, isn't it? As certain as death and taxes, as they say, so also is failure. With this new perspective, I have resolved to no longer fear failure. Because you see, I'd rather be happy and fail at what it is I want to do in my happy state than be miserable and succeed at that which I never truly wanted. Many of us have succeeded, including myself, in things that we thought would make us happy. Yet in the success of it, it felt off, unfulfilling, empty, like it never really truly mattered. It is not a brave thing to follow your dreams. You ought to follow your dreams. But I think it's a brave thing to admit that in the failure of your dreams, you would rather be than in the success of that which is not from you, which is not beneficial to you, which is not original to you, which is not authentic to you. And that is where I have found myself. the fear of failure, the fear of death, the fear of the end. That which is an end from one perspective is always a beginning from another perspective. Depending on your vantage point, the end of a seed usually means the beginning of a new growth. The end of night signifies the beginning of day, and so on and so forth. So, if you are listening to this and this has hit a nerve, I implore you to resolve within yourself to accept the inevitability of failure in perhaps all that you're about. In the acceptance of it, in the acceptance of the option of it, in the realization that it is not truly the end of anything, I think one's focus will be less split and one's focus will be more about being than it is about running away from the inevitable. We ought to be happy in all that we do. And you cannot be happy and fearful at the same time. The only way to overcome any kind of fear, including the fear of failure, is to accept that thing that you are afraid of. Accept its reality. Accept its possibility. Accept that it is not a definer of who you are. Accept that whether it comes or not, it ought not to shake or break or make you into what you think it will make you into. We are truly above this. I am above it. I just have to know it. I just have to view it from the right perspective. I have resolved within myself to no longer fear failure, because it is inevitable. It is a possibility. It is a reality. Why should I fear that which is? I came here to add to what is, not to be stopped by or to fear what is. I came here just like you to expand this reality with my own visions and my own contributions and my own unique way of perceiving things that have come from my unique experience in this world. So also you. And that has value. That has tremendous value. Everything new we're enjoying today in this world, every advancement that we are reveling in, that we are living in, came from someone or a group of people who have decided that they do not fear failure. Failure may be death, but death is not the end. For my evolution to continue, parts of me will have to die so that other parts may grow and live and expand and branch out. That's just how life works. That's just how life works. That's just how it is. Accepting what is the thing to do. And so it is safe to say that just because I can fail, just because I will fail, that does not make me a failure. Just because failing is a possibility does not make me a failure. Just because failing may even be a plausible thing, it does not a failure me make. And so with this, I journey onward. I journey forward. I keep going, not caring about failing anymore, because I've accepted its possibility. And I'm realizing more and more that it's ever almost always about the journey, and there really is no true end or destination. It is the journey. The journey, in a sense, is the destination. And if that's true, if that is the truth, then I have already succeeded, because I am moving forward. I am journeying forward. I am walking my path, carrying less fears, most of the fears being one of failing. And I am enjoying it, reveling in it, free from the trappings of fears, free from the weight of failure, free from the weight of fear.
It has been a pleasure bringing this soul-stirring study and conversation to you. I am Harry Ogbogu, and on behalf of those whose work and support made this production possible, I thank you and are grateful for the time I've spent with you, and are even more grateful for your upliftment and for any expansion of your understanding about who you are. Feel free to reach out to this podcast with comments and questions you are wanting answers to, and we shall address as many as we can on upcoming shows. No question is off limits. If we pick your letters or questions to address on the show, in order to protect your privacy, your name will not be used unless otherwise permitted expressly by you. Send your email questions and comments to harry@wayra.me. The email address again is harry@wayra.me. We would love for you to like, subscribe, and share this podcast, and we cannot wait to be heard by you again. Until next time, I am your host, Harry Ogbogu, and I am in joy of your company, and I pray that you are in joy of yours too. Stay being well.